the success of your surgery and recovery will be affected by how prepared you are. This section of the program describes some important steps you can take to get ready for the big day. These tips can help you prepare your body before you head into the operating room. Eat healthy foods like fruits, vegetables, lean meats, and whole grains. Get plenty of rest, reduce or quit smoking, and reduce or stop drinking alcohol. Your surgeon may ask you to start doing physical therapy exercises prior to surgery. If you have crutches or know someone that has crutches you could borrow, use them to practice walking around on one leg before you need to do it for real. If you happen to become ill within the days or weeks before your surgery, even if it's a simple cold, it's very important to contact us right away. We may need to delay your surgery until you're healthy again. If you have questions about billing, insurance, financial assistance, or charges for healthcare services, please contact Patient Financial Services at 800-368-4783 or 603-653-1047. The staff in Patient Financial Services is also happy to help those patients who do not have insurance coverage. Some patients will need a special appointment before the day of surgery. If your surgeon feels it's necessary, you may have an appointment in pre-admission testing. This department helps patients complete the necessary medical testing and paperwork for hospital registration. During the appointment, you will answer an anesthesia health quiz. This takes approximately 20 to 30 minutes using an electronic tablet. Your answers will provide your anesthesiologist with your specific health information that he or she will use to recommend anesthesia for your surgery. After completing your quiz, a nurse will meet with you to discuss any special needs you have. Depending on your medical history, you may have blood work drawn, a heart tracing or EKG, or a chest x-ray. Your surgeon will decide on which tests are necessary. Besides preparing yourself physically and mentally for your surgery, there are some practical things to think about. What should you pack for your trip to the hospital? Here are some suggestions. Bring a pair of flat, supportive, athletic or walking shoes so that you won't slip. Pack some loose-fitting clothes that will fit over a leg brace. Bring your eyeglasses instead of contacts. Glasses are easier to take care of, and you're less likely to lose them. Bring any dental devices, such as a retainer or dentures. We can give you a storage container if you need one. Bring a list of your daily medications, including the dosage and frequency, plus any medications that you stop taking in preparation for surgery. It's a good idea to bring a list of telephone numbers of people that you may want to call. Bring along the guidebook you were given to use as a reference and to make note of special instructions or questions you may have during your stay. The day before your surgery and the night before you come to the Dartmouth Hitchcock Medical Center, there are certain activities that you must do and some things you should avoid. You can enjoy a regular dinner on the night before your surgery. A nurse from the same day program will call you on the day before your surgery or on Friday if your operation is on Monday, and will leave a message if you're not at home regarding when to stop having anything to eat or drink, usually at midnight the night before surgery, which medications to take the morning before surgery, and what time you should plan to arrive at the outpatient surgery center. You may brush your teeth and rinse out your mouth the morning before surgery. You'll be given antibacterial soap packets called HibiCleanse. You will need to wash with this special soap the night before your surgery and the morning of your surgery to help decrease the chance of infection. If you did not receive the soap packet, or if you misplaced it, you can use another antibacterial soap, such as Dial. When you shower the night before and the day of your surgery, use a brush to scrub your nails. After your shower the night before surgery, put clean sheets on your bed and wear clean pajamas. Following these steps helps prevent infection. Remember, please leave all jewelry at home, including body piercings and all rings. Please do not shave your surgical area prior to your surgery. Your surgeon will inspect your knee the morning of your surgery and will carefully shave the area at that time. If there are breaks in your skin from your shaving, your surgery may need to be rescheduled because you may be at risk of developing an infection. Since you will have limited mobility after surgery, there are many changes that can be made to your home ahead of time to make life easier. Many of these things should be planned well in advance of your surgery date. To make your return home after surgery safer and more comfortable, there are some things you can do ahead of time to prepare your home. Get an apron that has pockets, which will help you carry items while you're using crutches. Place frequently used kitchen items like glasses or a teapot in an easy-to-reach place, such as on a countertop or on the lowest shelf in an overhead cabinet. Buy or make individual meals that can be frozen and easily reheated. Alert family and friends who can help you with your everyday needs. Be sure there is a clear path to the entrance of your home. Shovel snow from sidewalks and stairs, if you can do so safely, or ask a friend or family member to do it. Rake leaves so that you don't slip on them. Clear a path in the garage for easy access to your car. Clear clutter from the floors of your home and remove small area rugs so you don't trip and fall. Consider making arrangements for a friend or a kennel to care for your pets for the first few weeks after you return home. Pets may cause you to fall and re-injure your reconstructed knee. You will need to prepare your bathroom so you can shower safely during your recovery at home. Some patients like to use a handheld shower hose. Installing one is fairly easy and does not require a plumber. Place your soap, shampoo, and other toiletries in a spot where you don't have to bend or twist to reach them. A non-skid shower mat will reduce your chances of falling. Consider using a shower seat to make bathing easier and safer. Another important step in preparing for surgery is showering. This is another way you can help prevent infection from occurring after your procedure. Wash in the shower 2 times before your surgery, once the night before and the second time the morning of surgery. If you did not receive individual packages of HibaCleanse antibacterial wash at the time your surgery was set up, please substitute with an antibacterial soap such as Dial. Follow these steps when you're showering before surgery. Wet your entire body. Pour a palmful of soap into your hands. Rub the soap over your entire body from your neck to your toes. Wash thoroughly and rinse, avoiding the genital area. Pour another palmful of soap into your hands and rub it thoroughly over the surgical site using a fair amount of friction. Rinse and repeat steps 1 through 4. Then be sure to scrub under the fingernails and toenails. Read the directions of the HibaCleanse soap prior to use. Do not apply the soap to the head, face, eyes, mucous membranes, or genital area. This soap is for external use only. Do not use it on open wounds or damaged skin. Stop using HibaCleanse if redness or irritation develops. Do not drink this product. If some is swallowed, call poison control right away at 1-800-222-1222. After showering, do not put lotion or cream on the area where you're having your surgery. Be sure to wear clean pajamas after your shower on the evening before your surgery. Also, be sure to sleep in clean sheets that night. This is a lot to think about and to keep track of, but the more you do to prepare for your surgery, the better your outcome, and the safer and more comfortable your recovery will be.